नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, फ्रेंड्स, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स, स्पेसिफिकली फ्रॉम आर्ट एंड कल्चर एंड मेडिकल डोमेन्स। आई हैड वन ओपन एंडेड क्वेश्चन टू वन एंड ऑल। If our shastras or Vedas or Upanishads have the base study and base level in India itself, why is it so that we still have the quality guidelines or the guidelines set as per international standards? First question. And second question, when it comes to research and development aspects, this is specifically for medical field. When medicines or the medical symptoms or whatsoever have already been invented 10 to 15,000 years back, which Acharya Charaka has done a thorough research and produced his own theology, his own theory, his own expressing and his own findings and all, basing on that, why are we not taking that? I wouldn't want to take anybody's name. I wouldn't want to find fault with anyone in this field. Why are we still having that stigma that Western standards are the best standards? Why not Indian standards? Is it a thought-provoking point that we still are thinking that this is a base level? Not only that, even invention of aeroplane or invention of zero or invention of infinity, sorry about that. Why is it that we still are missing on this very key point? It's not that I am against anyone over here. Is this a failure of the system as such? I am making this an open-ended question, by the way. And I see many of them who got trained or who had the guidance of the Indian conditions and Indian environmental situations, why is it that they are so fascinated with the Western kind of thing? Nevertheless, we are having the ancestral lineage of Indic and Indus Valley civilization and Harappan civilization. Nevertheless, I do agree with that. Is it that the Indian government is running short of the institutionalized way of putting things? Or is it that we do not have those resources with us? It is really heartbreaking to see that. Recently, I have been seeing many of the Zoom meetings and many of the art and cultural related testimonies, and specifically in the field of classical art forms, or you know, classical art forms, be it dance, be it drawing, be it astronomical studies. Why is there still that stigma that we sitting in India, we do not have that institutionalized way of thinking or institutions that support this? What is that one barrier that is dividing? I felt really heart-wrenching. It was really heartbreaking. In fact, I was very much annoyed when I saw what you call Tom Schwartz speaking about souls and its inferences, rather than exploring and exploiting the subject in the way Vedas and Puranas were telling. He was trying to implore over the subject and exploit the same. Likewise, for the same, fake gurus like Nityananda, Rampal, Ram Rahim, etc., etc., you name them, they justifying the yoga from the Maya and Mahamaya point of view at a very irrational way of justifying the subject. Why? And when it comes to dance form, on which I have been looking at it from past almost like 6 years now, and I have seen very few of the legendary gurus who have worked on it, like late Dr. Vempati Chinnasatyam Master Garu or late Dr. Vedantam Satyanarayan Sharma Garu, who have done their works. And they rather, what they did was, they exploited the subject in depth and into the deeper aspect and trained their students in such a way that they could get molded and they could become the torch bearers for propagating this subject around the world. And they are doing it. And Kalams are in the educational field, having quit the presidential terms. Though he may have served 5 years, but he never wanted to continue in the educational field. And he did that until the last breath. He continued his services in the educational field. Are there no institutions in India that could fund on this scientific analysis? Are there no scholars who think from this point of view? If they are scholars, why is it that this so-called pseudo and fake gurus like Nityananda, Rampal, Ram Rahim, etc., etc., are exploiting? And yoga from the viewpoint of space and time travel, that medieval rishis, munis, and Brahma rishis who have done enough of penance and enough of spiritual practices and rituals which had their own meaning, are not being exploited and explored over and tried out in the 21st century, which is becoming a very much advanced level of study. My point is, have we failed on this? Or are we being ignorant and arrogant over the fact that no, we do not have resources in our own motherland, that is Indian subcontinent, where Vedas and Upanishads were born, with enough of gamut of subject which has been exploited from the imploring point of view rather than exploring point of view. When I say imploring, they just implored. They didn't explore over the subject. Today, Westerners are getting attracted to the Indian traditions. And I don't see many of the gurus from the Indian cult . Maybe I might be harsh, maybe I might be what you call blunt on my statements. I am not trying to find fault, or I am not trying to demean any of the scholars in their respective domains who are actually in the research field, R&D field, trying to look at it. The funny part over here is, authentically we had around 1130 Vedas, 1130 plus Vedas, I would rather say. This is the approximate figure I am giving you, Vedas and Upanishads. And it further got reduced to 7. These 7 further got reduced or condensed to the 4 Vedas: Rig Veda, Yajurveda, Atharvan Veda, and Sama Veda. And then Upavedas came. Like this, there have been many additions and deletions, I agree. over a period of centuries. As the centuries pass by, are we not fading over the subject? Everyone had their own theology, everyone had their own swadharma. They have left dharma and manodharma the aspect of this. Here is where Chanakya's role comes into picture. When Chanakya was in Magadha, he had faced the same situation, and thus he revived the situation by accepting this challenge, by establishing the truth that this is from our motherland. When I say our motherland, from this place, this has evolved. However, it is not an ego concept over here, but from the place where subject has evolved in its own, if it is not being expressed and this is being implored by others by way of stealing the sacred texts or the sacred verses or the sacred scriptures, and this being deciphered in westernization, there is enough of proof and enough of evidence that most of the treasury of the ancient scriptures of Vedas and Upanishads, Upavedas, you name it, these scriptures have been stolen by the Westerners, and they have been misinterpreted, unfortunately. For example, Kama Sutra, Vatsayana's Kama Sutra. Today that is being taken as a sex symbol, or that is being taken as a, a subject which cannot be taught in the general public. But Vatsayana's Kama Sutra is a very divine act, and it has the divinity in it. It was told by Nandi to Vatsayana, and Vatsayana further transcribed and put that as a part of text. Is it that the Yugas are playing into picture? Let's talk about the yoga part. Yoga means traveling between space and time, understanding how the soul travels in the space and what is the time frame that the soul travels and what is its inference when it comes to understanding of Nitya and Anitya, real and unreal concept, and going beyond the Anitya point and realizing into the realizing yourself at the highest level. Have we not failed in that? My only question to everyone, whoever are into the traditional practices in whichever form, be it yoga, be it meditation, be it art, in art, classical dance, dance, drawing, astronomy, astrology, rituals, Brahmanical rituals, Brahmanical rites. I am speaking almost all the parts of Shastras, even Agama Shastra, Friends, I have just this an open-ended, I am keeping it as an open-ended question to everyone. It is an open-ended question. Don't you think that we have failed in this miserably, in understanding the growth aspect or the primary aspect of it? To cite you an example, the one unfortunate incident that have had happened over the and have been happening and is happening till date is that we still have a strong feeling that whatever shastras that are existing or whatever rituals or the or Brahmanism or Brahmanical way of thinking established from one specific city, right from Sangam civilization to Bhagavatars or Bhagavatars, from Sangam civilization to Bhagavatars. I am not specifying one specific thing. I am addressing to everyone across globe. Iranians giving their own definition of Brahmanism or Brahmanical rites. Fake gurus giving their own definition. Funny part is, why are doctors asking for the evidence or the proof? Why? Let me clarify on this and get back to you on the same. I will clarify in detail. If one is asking for a proof or one is asking for a evidence, one is asking for whatever proof that you want. Friends, understand this. Our ancient literatures or Vedas and Upavedas or Upanishads or Kandas, Brahma Kanda or any kind of history didn't have any shakhas as such. There was no division at all. It was only one single concept. Shastras were only the one thing, and which is what Indic culture or Indus Valley civilization had followed, or Harappan civilization, Harappa Mohenjo-daro. Coming to the classical dance form, when I talk about classical dance form came into existence because this classical dance is one medium, very easy medium, wherein you can transcribe all the Vedas, Upanishads, Upavedas, stories in the story format and create that regeneration or create that self-realization point in one's mind. This was the very basic purpose of Natya being introduced And in fact, we have missed on this. It has to be understood now. It's high time that we, as individuals, are we doing justice to this? Going beyond Nitya and Anitya point, that is the infinity point. Recently I was seeing one of the videos, I wouldn't want to say, name him. He was telling about the mantra japa. Even before practicing mantra japa, one needs to understand the tantra aspect in that. If you are overcoming that tantra aspect, that's when you will get to understand the mantra's effect on the body. And he or she, when he or she is getting into that self-realization point, he would get to that infinity point. And he would not be able to see even that infinity. Then how come this gentleman was telling me that, telling in the video that he had a mantra meter? Sad and pathetic part. The reason is they have never understood the shastras in depth or the deeper aspect of it. My point is, this is just an instance that I am giving. How many of us really believe that for any kind of shastra, be it Arogya Shastra, be it Natya Shastra, be it any kind of Shastra, Vaimanika Shastra, or any kind of Shastra. Shastras, understanding the Shastras is the pillar. Sorry about that. When you are able to understand the meaning of Shastras, that's when you would be able to explore and exploit. This is the worst part, or the, you know, funny part is Westerners are encashing on that. And they have been exploiting for years and years together. Recently I had seen a video wherein Westerner was talking about what has happened to the Indians who are born in the Indian soil. Staying in India, India being the motherland of everything, are we running short of the resources for these kind of research and development activities? Developmental activities? Can we not look at that from the broader sense and vivid sense, or the wider market aspect? Let's not try to market on the subject. The funny part is, we are not trying to get the gist of it. The takeaway or the cofactors or the factors from this video to understand is, have that open-ended question and try to question yourself. Can we try to explore and exploit the subject of Vedas, Upavedas, Upanishads, and various other scriptures in the motherland itself, having that institutionalized or the schematic way or the structured way of thinking to establish the truth of the Vedas beneath and above all. I'm keeping it as an open-ended question for everyone, every research scholar, every single person who is into fine arts, yoga, meditative practices, cultural activities, drawing, medical field, whatnot, every part of it, irrespective of medical advancement or medical technological advancements or technological advancements. Think about it, ladies and gentlemen. My prime reason for doing this video is I was deeply hurt with the fact that Westerners are speaking, but not a single Indian till date had tried to explain the core concept of the subject. If I had seen an Indian doing it, the Indian was sitting in Western countries and trying to do it, but not staying in India and having that research and developmental faculties that are there happening. It was really heartbreaking. And in case if I see also there are one or two, I can count on fingers. Thus I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with you. Have a nice day.